Hello, my dear children. Good morning to one and all. So, in the last class, we have learnt understanding diversity. Our country is being diversified with lot of new culture, new tradition, new religion, as well as even our practices are also being different from one person to another person. So you have understood the meaning of diversity, and that diversity only has created unity among the people in our country. So in this today's class, we are going to learn a new things about hunting gathering to the growing food. Okay, you are going to learn a history topic called hunting gathering to the growing food. So in what way, what is hunting and gathering, and what is growing food? We know the agriculture is being practiced for a long years ago. So why this hunting and gathering came into existence, how, in which, and how the human beings came into existence in our country as well as in the world, in which period, in which year the human beings were been originated, these all things you are going to learn in this today's session. Okay, these are the pictures of early people. Those were doing hunting and gathering. They were gathering the food. So first one, introduction. Evolution of man, that is human beings. The Stone Age. Archaeological artifacts. Place. The beginning of farming and herding. New life, artifacts, settled life. So among those, by reading all these content, you are going to learn one case study which is relating the Stone Age. That place is called as a Mehergarh. So about that one you are going to learn in this topic there. So elsewhere, not only in our country we will see the Stone Age, in different parts of the countries also we will see the Stone Age was been existing in the world long back ago. Okay, so do you know what, ma'am, you will ask. So our earth came into existence nearly past million years ago. Yes, nearly 4,600 million years our Earth ages. Scientists believe that the life began on the Earth somehow 3,500 million years ago. So man evolved over the centuries in the stages from ape to present day of a man. Ape means monkey. From monkey to the present day of a man, nearly took million and billion years to become a human beings there. So this procedure took place nearly long million and billion years back. Most probably, according to the scientist, the human beings of today developed 2 or 1.5 million years ago. Human beings who lived about 2 million years ago were the nomads and hunters and the gatherers. Nomads means from one place to another place they used to wander, as well as they used to go from one place to another place there. So do you know why the hunter and gatherers name came into existence for these kind of people, that is nomad people? So because of their the food that they were using. So the people those were living during that time, they did not live in one place for a long time. Okay, so in to gather in a group of people only, they used to go from one place to another place in the search of food. So that is why whatever kinds of food they used to get in that area, they used to hunt it. By hunting the animals, or they used to gather the food like fruits, nuts, etc. So because of their food, what they were using, they got the name called hunters and the gatherers. So first only I have told these people they were moving in a group only. They used to hunt the animals in a group. They used to do the fishing as well as they used to catch the birds. As well as they used to gather the fruits, nuts, roots, leaves, as well as seeds, vegetables, etc. for their livelihood. Then how these human beings came into existence? So what all the archaeological artifacts, what all the things we will get to understand, these people, they were living in a million and billion year back. Okay. So according to the some scientists, human beings are ape developed from the common ancestor, but evolved independently after they separated from their ancestors. Okay, so understand this. I'm going to show one picture. You can see. Okay, so this is the ape, that is monkey. So you can see one evolution. So slowly he started walking and he started standing on the behalf of two legs. Afterwards, he started walking. Okay, we can see some changes in the facial expression also. So in this way, the present human beings, what we are seeing. So this could happen million and billion year back from ape, that is from monkey, to the present day of human beings. So this we call it as a theory of evolution. So this was propounded by the Charles Darwin. He was one of the famous scientist. He told about the origin of human beings from monkey to the human beings there. So these are monkeys are our ancestors. So after a lot of changes took place, you can see some changes in the three stages. So they separated from their ancestors, that is from monkeys. They started separating, they gathering the people in a separate area. They used to live in that area only. They used to live, they used to communicate with the people in that region only. So in this way, the human beings came into existence nearly 2 or 1 million years back. So hunter and gatherers, I have told, they used to move from one place to another place. So what are the reasons behind why they not settled in one area? Why they used to go from one place to another place? So there are several reasons why the hunters and the gatherers, they were moving from one place to another place. So according to the first reason, they had stayed at one place for a long time, they would have eaten up all kind of food which was available in the form of plant as well as in the form of animal resource. How they used to eat all kind of availability. So I have told the human beings were being evolved from their ancestors from ape to the human beings. So at present day, what kind of thinking capacity and what kind of activities we are doing, that was unavailable during that time. Okay, whatever resource they were finding by seeing in the forest area, they used to eat all kind of fruits. They used to hunt the animals in that region only. Once, if that came to an end, they used to move further for searching a new kind of food where they will get the food as well as animal resource there for their livelihood. So why they were not staying at the one place means they would to eat up all kind of availability, that is plants and animal resource. They don't know how to do the farming during that time. They were also not knowing to cook the food when they were being evolved from the human beings, from monkey to the human beings. So you all know that animals, always they used to move from one place to another place in search of their food also. So to hunt the animals also, these hunters and the gatherers, they used to move from one place to another place. So the plants, trees, as well as bare fruits, in a different season, it was been available in the different parts of the country. So the people, they were moving from one season to another season in search of plant as well as in the search of fruits. People, plants, animals need water to survive. Okay, without water human beings cannot survive. We all know the importance of water. So the water availability was found in the lakes, in the streams, as well as in the rivers. So in that region only they used to concentrate, as well as in that area only they used to live for a long time. Some rivers were been called as a perennial rivers, and another rivers were called as a non-perennial rivers. What is this perennial and non-perennial? Perennial means throughout the year, throughout 12 months the river will flow. So that kind of rivers we call it as a perennial rivers. Non-perennial rivers means during the summer season, the water existing, it will be evaporated, as well as it will get the dry. So it will not flow throughout the year. So that kind of rivers we call it as a non-perennial rivers. This is the difference between perennial and non-perennial. So wherever perennial rivers were been available throughout the year, they used to live in that area there. So sources to find about these people. So I have told lot of things about hunters and the gatherers. Then one question will be raised in your mind: how you have came to know about these people, about the evolution of the man, about the earth existence? So in this period only the human beings came into existence, I have told. Then what are the sources to find out them? Because to read the history, you have came to know the importance of sources there. Okay, without sources, the historians as well as the archaeologists, they can't reconstruct the history and they can present in front of you people. So some sources are there to find out about these people. So through that sources only we came to know about these people, as well as in this period only the people were been living. Okay, so archaeologists found some of the things that these people were using during that time. So it is likely that people made some tools of stone, wood, bone, of which the stone tools have survived best. Okay, so these tools were made up of wood. These tools were been made up of stone, and some of the using strong bone. They used to make the weapons there. Some of the tools were been used to cut the meat, to cut the bone, as well as to cut the animals. Some of the tools were been used to bark leaves, that is to bark the trees. Some of the tools they used to cut the animal skin to get the flesh, raw flesh, to chop the fruits, and to chop the roots which are been eatable. So some of the tools were used to hunt the animals, to chop the wood which was used as a firewood. Wood was also used to make some of the hut, as well as some of the tools during that time. So by seeing these tools only we came to know about these people, that these are the weapons they were using to hunt the animals, as well as to chop the roots, fruits, etc. for their usage there. Okay, so next one is a place. So in which kind of places the people were been living? So all the places marked in a red triangles. So afterwards I am going to show one India map. So in that you will come to know the places where these people were been living. So the archaeologists have found out the evidence of hunters and gatherers in that area only. So many of the sites, many of the places were been located near the source of water, such as where the rivers were been flowing, where the lakes are been there. So in that area only these hunters and the gatherers, we will find some of the evidences there. So this is the picture of some of the tools which were been used during that time. These were been buried under the earth surface when the archaeologists excavated. When they started digging the earth, they found some of the unique tools. So when they found that unique tools, they started reading about that one. So with the help of some chemicals, they tested on these tools, and they came to know that these tools were in existence nearly million and billion year back. So during that time, some human beings were been existed. So they started searching about the human beings which were been survived in the Stone Age. So as a stone, our tools were been very important, and people tried to find out the place where they used to get the good quality of stone was easily available for them, and in those area only most of the people were been concentrated. And even some rock paintings. So this is an example of rock painting which was been available in a place called Bhimbetka, which is situated in the Madhya Pradesh. So in that area, in among the cave, they find out some unique paintings, and by seeing that unique paintings only, they came to know that long years back some people were been living in a cave places. Okay, in that area only they used to find those tools, and they used to find some of the pots. So that the historians assumed, as well as they came to one conclusion, that when the human beings were been came into existence, first they used to live in the caves. So that is why we are getting all kind of evidences in the rock as well as in the caves. So many caves in which these early people lived have paintings on the wall. Some of the best example where we will get this kind of painting in our country is Madhya Pradesh and southern Uttar Pradesh. So these paintings show the wild animals drawn and a great accuracy and the skill. You can see what kind of skill they were having, and what kind of animals were been there during that time. That animals we can't see at the present situation because they have already came to an end. So by seeing these kind of animals, different kinds of pictures of animals, they came to know maybe the different animals they were living million and billions year back, now we are not having that existence. So by seeing this, they came to know about varieties of wild animals and the people's skill, because they were doing the drawing. With that drawing only, they used to communicate from one person to another person. Then what do you mean by sites then? I have told many things about sites, places. Then what is a site? Site is nothing but the places where the remains of the things were being found. So in which area we will find out all kind of remains, we call that place as a site. So these were made, used and left behind by the people nearly long era back. These may found on the earth surface, buried under the earth surface, or sometime even underwater. So this kind of places in a history, in a historical terms, we call it as a sites. Okay, so in the last class, before I have told some of the place name which has been marked in the red color. So you can see one is Bhimbetka, Hunasgi, Karnul Caves. Okay, you can see in a triangle shape here. Okay, so these three places, can you see these are located near the riverside area? Yes or no, children? These are located in the nearby the river only, these are being located. Why? The human beings, they started searching the water for their survival. So wherever they were getting the water existence and abundance of food, they used to live in that area for a long time. And afterwards, he started using the rocks in the form of caves. He started making the caves, and in that cave only he started living. Slowly he started settle down in his life near the riverside area only. So these artifacts, whatever I have told, that is stone tools, paintings, etc., we have got near the riverside area only. Okay, so in the next class, I am going to explain about the divisions of Stone Age, which is the first Stone Age, second and third, and how the fire came into existence, how the people started cooking their food, and some changes took place in the earth, in the environment. After that changing of the environment, what are the changes took place in the human being's life? New way, new life was being started of the human beings. In what way? In the next class, I am going to explain about this. Factors then. I hope today's class you have understood about early human beings, how the human beings came into existence in the world. So signing out, have a great day. Bye everyone.